What a lot of schools failed at, the protesting farmers accomplished. Thinking about a school, we think about 30 to 40 students in a classroom. Here we're talking about more than a million protesting farmers. I'd like to present to you 10 facts why the protesting farmers are our best moral science teachers. So schools, take notes. Number one, the farmers fed the same people who attacked them with tear gas, water cannons and batons. They taught us the art of compassion, forgiveness and humility. Number two, they keep the area clean and their children have been actively cleaning the streets. They say that they wouldn't want the localites to say that the protesters came over and created a mess. What do we see? That they're considerate and hygienic. Number three, they've carried their own ration. This shows self-reliance, or in the Prime Minister's term, Atmanirbharta. They're feeding people who have been neglected by the government. Underprivileged children say that they have never seen so much food in their lives. The farmers have also arranged blood donation camps and they've been donating blood. Families of patients have sent their blessings to farmers. We appreciate how selfless the farmers are, and that's something to learn from them. During Guru Purab or Guru Nanak Dev Ji's Jayanti, the farmers did not burst firecrackers. They chose to light candles instead. They're farmers. They're the closest to nature. They're environment conscious and responsible. Therefore, they're an asset to the environment and the community. Number five, for sanitation, they've carried portable toilets. They acknowledge that there is an issue with the demand to supply ratio, but they're being proactive about it and they've ordered for more sanitation equipment. We learn the art of taking responsibility, being accountable and proactive from them. Number six, the farmers are making their kids study at the protest site. They show their children that you can protest to claim your rights, but education continues, no excuses. They're not only the hands that feed the nation, but they're also amazing parents. The farmers have taken the neglected kids under their wing. They're not only feeding them, but they're also educating them along with their kids. How empowering. Number seven, the farmers have opened public libraries at various spots. They get their local newspaper delivered daily to them. They call out negative and fake journalism and promote positive journalism. They also critically analyze social media and give their input. They are well informed and highly intelligent. In fact, they've been dropping gems of wisdom, such as speaking in English, wearing jeans and shirts, or having degrees does not define one's intellect. This is exactly what self-help coaches and therapists around the world have been repeatedly telling their patients who may just be doctors and engineers. Number eight, the farmers refused the food that was offered to them by the ministers during the meetings. In fact, they carried their own food and followed the concept of langar, which is why they sit down together to eat, which shows equality among all humans, and the food is free irrespective of creed, religion and caste. This shows integrity and religious tolerance, and they're also putting equality of humans into practice. World human rights organizations must be inspired by this practice. Number nine, the elders who are in their 80s, 90s or more have been staying put in the freezing cold climate of Delhi. Now the temperature is below 5 degrees Celsius and this climate really challenges one's intentions, but the farmers are tolerating it at the risk of COVID-19, adverse health conditions and even death without retaliating. Despite all this, they stay peaceful, resilient and non-violent, proving time and again that they are here only to claim their livelihood, which is at stake. Number 10. Despite all the dehumanizing acts against them, like physically attacking them, psychologically attacking them by deeming repeated meetings inconclusive, defaming them by calling them anti-national separatists and Khalistanis, or trying to handicap them by associating their articles of faith like the Khanda or Nishan Sahib and the saffron color with violence and terrorism, they stay put. They stay peaceful and they wish you peace too. While protesting, they're operating from a space of compassion. Why? Because they're literally feeding people with their own hands, literally sharing the fruit of their labor with the others. Blessed and honored are you who has been fed by our farmer.